Alright guys, we're back staring at my engine bay, and in this video I'm going to show you how to calibrate the electronic wastegate. And this is something where we have a lot of misunderstanding around what's actually happening, so I'm going to try to clarify what's actually happening when you calibrate your wastegate and what it isn't, and then I'll show you guys the different ways to do it. So obviously having an electronic wastegate has a lot of benefits, and that's why a lot of different cars have electronic wastegates now. But the pneumatic wastegates were really simple and really easy to use because they just relied on ambient pressure and spring pressure inside of the wastegate to keep everything regulated. But when you have an electronic wastegate, there's no actual point of reference. So it needs to be able to know how far open the wastegate should open and how far closed it needs to be closed at any given time so that it can control your boost pressure properly. And that's why it's important to make sure that your wastegate is calibrated properly. Now, this isn't a common issue in the same sense as my other B58 common issue videos. This is something that you really should only face if you are replacing your turbo. So if you're replacing your stock unit or maybe upgrading to an aftermarket one that reuses the electronic wastegate, you'll need to make sure that your wastegate is calibrated. But if you're having like boost control issues or wastegate duty cycle issues, this isn't necessarily something that will fix that. And here's why. So this is the electronic wastegate on my car, and you can see I have it adapted to an aftermarket turbo, but if you have the stock turbo, you'll have the exact same thing in a similar position. And every time you start the car, the wastegate actually calibrates itself. So this is something, again, I think there's a misunderstanding because of the wording that we use when we talk about this process, but the wastegate calibrates itself every time you turn on the car. You can actually see it. The wastegate arm sucks all the way in to find the closed position, and then it extends all the way out to find the open position. And when it does that, it uses that information for the entire rest of your drive so that it knows how much to open and close to give you, you know, the right amount of boost. However, what you do need to do is make sure that the wastegate is adjusted within a range where it can calibrate itself. So what you see on the end of here is this threaded rod, and that rod is completely adjustable, so you can screw it in or screw it out to make the length of the wastegate within tolerance. And that's what you're actually doing when people say you need to calibrate your wastegate after replacing your turbo. So that's what's actually happening. And again, sorry for anything I've said that might have contributed to the misinformation, but you're not actually calibrating your wastegate. You're just adjusting the length of the wastegate arm to make sure that it is within spec. Now, the good news is if you are having an issue that requires calibrating the wastegate, you will know it immediately because, like I said, it checks for that fully open and fully closed position as soon as you start the car. You don't even actually need to turn over the engine. If you just put it on in accessory mode where it's running off the battery, it'll run through that process to make sure that the wastegate can find its open and closed position. So if it can't do that, it'll throw a drivetrain malfunction, and if you scan for codes, you'll basically see one of two different things. So if you see this code or some variation of it, then you know that the wastegate can't find the closed position. So that means when the arm is sucked all the way in, it's not seeing the resistance that it expects when the wastegate flap is fully closed. Now, if you see this code, that means that it can't find the open position. So when the wastegate is fully extended, it's not seeing the resistance that it expects when the flap is all the way open. Now, there are a lot of different variations of this code. You know, they vary with like the final digits and things like that, but just kind of read the wording and that'll tell you whether it's struggling to find the open position or the closed position. So now let's talk about how to fix this issue. And the easiest way to do it is to set the wastegate to its perfect length. And the way that the wastegate is set up, if the wastegate arm is extended 26 millimeters from the base, then the wastegate should be completely closed. So if you have the room to actually get a ruler in there, you can measure the length of the wastegate arm, and at 26 millimeters, it should be fully closed. Now, unfortunately, the wastegate doesn't stop in the fully closed position, so usually the wastegate is extended a little bit past that 26 millimeter perfect position. So I'm gonna show you guys how I get it perfect, and sorry in advance, there's a little bit of math and we're gonna talk numbers, so hopefully that doesn't bother you guys too much. So let's say I measure the wastegate arm and it's extended to 31 millimeters. So that means it's 5 millimeters outside of the perfectly closed position. What I'm going to do is adjust the wastegate and tighten it down so that it's perfectly closed. And then I'm going to measure how much is left over on the end. So if there's an extra like 10 millimeters of threaded rod past it, then I'm gonna thread it out so there's only 5 millimeters left. And that basically compensates for the extra extension on the wastegate. So you want to see how far away the wastegate arm is from that 26 millimeter position, and then adjust the wastegate to that same length so that you know when the wastegate adjusts to that perfect position, the wastegate will be closed. So if you have the room to do this, it's really easy. You don't have to do any kind of trial and error or anything like that. You know that you're setting it to the perfect position, and as soon as you turn on the car, your drivetrain malfunction will go away. Now, if you're not able to measure the wastegate, then you can still do the trial and error method. And like I said, as soon as you turn on the car, if it's out of calibration, it'll throw a drivetrain malfunction, and when you scan for codes, you'll see exactly what's wrong. And in order to get some guidance on what you need to do, all you need is to read the code. If the code says that it cannot find the closed position, then that means that you need to shorten the length of the wastegate. So loosen the nuts and suck it in a little bit more and then tighten it back down. If it says that it cannot find the open position, then that means that you need to extend the length of the wastegate. So again, loosen the nuts, push it out, and then tighten it back down. Now, unfortunately, it might take a couple tries at this to get it, but like I said, just adjust it, go back in the car, turn it on in accessory mode, and see if your code goes away. And when you don't have that code anymore, then you know that the length of the wastegate arm is within the tolerance. Now, the last method, and the one that I was originally using, is Ista, and I think you guys know I'm a big advocate of Ista. If you don't have it, look around on the internet. There are plenty of places to buy it or download it, but it is a really nice tool because it can tell you exactly how much to adjust the wastegate when it runs that calibration procedure. Now, of course, if you can measure it yourself, you can just set it to nominal, but this tool still has a lot of nice features linked to the wastegate where you can do any kind of test that you want to make sure everything's good. Now, I've posted the entire ISTA procedure for people that are curious about that. It's on the end of all of my DIYs for my turbo replacements, and I'll also add it here so you guys can see what the process looks like. But basically, you click through the menus and it'll run through that calibration process on its own. It'll tell you if there are any faults, and if there are any issues, it'll also suggest ways that you can fix it. So again, really nice software. If all you're doing is adjusting the wastegate, it's probably not a big deal, but it is a nice tool that can give you other options. So that's how we fix any wastegate calibration issues that you guys might have. Again, this is a process that you can do yourself because all you're doing is adjusting the length of the wastegate, so you don't need to hire a coder or have people like remote in and log into your car or do any tuning or anything. You're simply adjusting the length of that wastegate arm so that it's within the tolerance where the wastegate can calibrate itself. So I hope this video helps. Thanks again for watching. And if you guys have any other questions or comments, leave them down below. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do